The situation is most unfortunate, but I don't make the rules.
But you do play the game, don't you, Garak? And there is a game being played right now as we speak, isn't there?
There are always games, Doctor.
The trouble is, I don't have the slightest idea what this game is all about. So you're going to tell me what's going on inside that plain and simple head of yours, my Cardassian friend, or we're going to sit here until we rot.
Was Gul Dukat.
No, thank you, Doctor. I'm quite full.
But you've hardly touched your food.
Well, the truth is, I'm trying to lose a little weight. Hemming women's dresses may provide me with a modest income, but it offers very little in the way of exercise.
Well, if you like, I can help you set up an exercise program in one of the holosuites.
I might just...
Look, Garak, in 2 days I turn 30. If I choose to be grumpy about it, that's my prerogative.
By all means, Doctor, be as grumpy as you like.
Well, thank you for the support.
Menu. At the bar.
Goodbye, Quark.
Don't take it personally. He's turning 30. It's a pity about Lieutenant Dax.
How'd you know about her?
I'm a part of you, remember? I know what you know. Well, maybe a little more.
Still the man of mystery.
Oh, you wouldn't have me any other way.
But really, Doctor, there was no harm done.
They broke 7 of your transverse ribs and fractured your clavicle.
Ah, but I got off several cutting remarks, which no doubt did serious damage to their egos.
Garak, this isn't funny.
I'm serious, Doctor. Thanks to your ministrations, I'm almost completely healed. But the damage I did to them will last a lifetime. Perhaps they decided they just didn't like me.
Not like you. Impossible.
You're right. As always, Doctor.
Well, tell me, Doctor, what is it exactly about this situation that's making you smile?
You, Garak.
Hmm?
Just wondering how many other tailors can rewrite Cardassian security protocols.
I wouldn't even venture a guess. Which reminds me, those pants you wanted altered are ready to be picked up.
Garak! Easy, Doctor!
Garak, this isn't helping.
Wait a minute. What about the power supply?
It's far deeper than that, Doctor. Ever since you received this new program, you've spent virtually every free hour in the holosuite. But you haven't told anyone what the program is.
Am I supposed to?
No. But you're such a, forgive me, a talkative man. And it's so unusual for you to have secrets.
Oh, I must have picked up that habit from you. Now, if you will excuse me.
Is this fantasy of yours truly revealing of your inner psyche?
What?
Is that why you're so protective? Are you afraid that I'll find out some humiliating secret?
I'm not hiding anything.
Well, if you've nothing to hide, then why not let me stay?
All right.
Artificial.
So, that's not so difficult. One only has to...
Garak!
Your friend seems to know something.
Believe me, he knows nothing.
Computer, show me the mechanism! Oh!
You'll be fine. It's just a flesh wound.
That was awfully close. What if you killed me?
What makes you think I wasn't trying?
Doctor, I do believe there's hope for you yet.
Did you see the way she gave him the tiniest head fake and then boom, checked him into the wall?
Yes, it was quite effective.
Stop watching her.
Oh, I thought the whole point was to watch.
The point is to watch the game, not the spectators, especially not that spectator.
Perhaps I should say hello after the game.
That's Gul Dukat's daughter, and I can't think of anyone in the galaxy who hates you more than he does. Besides, Zial is a friend of Kira's, and I wouldn't play around with her if I were you.
I simply thought it would be polite to say hello, but clearly you don't think I'm capable of conducting any kind of pleasant discourse without some kind of nefarious, ulterior motive.
That's not what I meant. I just think you should leave well enough alone.
Garak.
Garak, you have to stop. You're making
Too much noise. Garak.
The light. The light went out.
I know. Come on. I think you can take your break a little early.
Well, if it hadn't happened, we'd never have discovered Rugal's situation. And a bite in the hand is certainly worth saving a boy's life, wouldn't you say?
I suppose it depends on whose hand. Just joking, Doctor.
But...
No air, bad lighting, random electric shocks. It's perfect.
Sounds like you're enjoying yourself.
If you'd like, I'd happily trade places with you.
I suppose you could give me a crash course in Cardassian field engineering. I should be ready to take over from you in, what, 5 or 6 weeks?
That was thoroughly unpleasant.
Are you all right?
I'm fine. It's just... much hotter in there than I thought. I got a little lightheaded. Give me a minute and I'll go back in there.
No, you need more than a minute. Your pulse is racing. I don't want to think about your blood pressure. Maybe you should wait until tomorrow.
Do you want to get off this hellhole
or
not?
You know I do.
Then let me get back to work.
Rest for 5 minutes. And from here on in, you can take a 15-minute break every hour. Doctor's orders.
At this rate, we'll be done eating lunch just in time for dinner.
Well, there's always quarks.
True, but I'm really not in the mood for noisy, crowded, and vulgar today.
I suppose the Klingon restaurant is out of the question.
I can't believe that I'm having lunch with a man who thinks the never-ending sacrifice is dull.
Oh, I just thought the story got a little redundant after a while. Are you all right?
I'm fine.
You don't look fine. Your skin is clammy and your pupils have contracted.
I assure you, I'm in perfect health. Now, you were asking about other Cardassian books. Something maybe a little more accessible.
Perfect health. Then Cardassian standards must be a little lower than mine. Come on.
May I join? Garak.
Thank you.
What are you doing up? You're supposed to be in bed.
Out of the question. I couldn't stand being cooped up in that dreadful infirmary for another second. Besides, I feel perfectly fine. So, how's the Idanian spice pudding today?
How's the spice pudding? Is that all you have to say for yourself?
I've brought you something.
What is it?
Meditations on a Crimson Shadow by Prelock.
More Cardassian literature.
I think you'll find this one more to your taste. It takes place in the future, during a time when Cardassia and the Klingon Empire are at war.
Who wins?
Who do you think?
Never mind. Don't tell me. I don't want you to spoil the ending.
What's all this?
He came in complaining about a headache. The next thing I knew, he drank up half my stock of Canar.
Doctor! What a... pleasant surprise. I apologize for my outburst at lunch, but I promise I'll make it up to you. Please, join me.
I think I will. May I?
By all means. What are you doing?
I think it's a little noisy in here. I prefer to drink somewhere quiet.
An excellent idea. We'll go to my quarters.
Whatever you want.
There you are. I was beginning to give up hope, Doctor. I would think that all those lunches we've shared would have entitled me to preferential treatment.
Look, I have 12 wounded officers and crewmen out there, all of whom are in a lot worse shape than you, Garak.
Well, if you're trying to cheer me up, it's working. I feel better already.
I admit the odds are not good, but they could be worse.
Let me guess. You've used your genetically enhanced brain to calculate our chances for survival.
It really wasn't that difficult. I simply started with a binomial.
I'm really not interested, Doctor. Ever since it's become public knowledge that you're genetically engineered, you've used every opportunity to show off.
I have nothing to hide anymore. I might as well use what I have.
Well, what are our chances? Over 50%?
32.7.
I'm sorry I asked. You're certain about that figure?
Do you want me to take you through the entire set of calculations?
Not really. Genetically engineered, indeed.
Excuse me?
Well, look at you. You act as if you haven't a care in the world. It's exactly that kind of smug, superior attitude that makes people like you so unpopular.
Are you trying to insult me?
A 32.7% chance of survival. I call that insulting.
Don't take it so personally, Garak. It's strictly a matter of mathematics.
No, it's strictly a matter of our lives.
Garak, come to see us off?
Not quite.
I invited Mr. Garak to join us, considering we're heading into Cardassian territory. I thought he might prove useful.
Well, it's been known to happen.
Well, the headsets were designed to be worn by the Vorta and the Jem Hadar, not humans.
Captain, may I make a suggestion?
Only if you talk softly.
We saw Dukat wearing one of these headsets during the attack on Deep Space Nine. Perhaps Cardassian physiology is more compatible.
Are you volunteering?
I suppose I am. This ship is equipped with two of them. If I wore one, then you wouldn't have to. At least, not all the time.
I agree with Garak, Captain. The less you wear it, the better.
Doctor, are you in a hurry?
I have to get to the infirmary. I've got a lot of work to do this afternoon.
Oh, you're fortunate. I have more time in my hands than I know what to do with.
Maybe you can finish those trousers I dropped off last week.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow.
You're going to give yourself indigestion.
Well, I only have you to thank for that. If you hadn't been so late, I could have enjoyed my lunch.
It is a very interesting sociological phenomenon, don't you think? For generations now, humankind has had more than enough food, and yet you go about your eating as if you were afraid someone was going to come along and snatch away your plate.
Garak, why don't you eat for a while and let me talk?
Fear of starvation amid plenty. It points to some dark secret hidden in the human soul, a gnawing hunger. Perhaps someone should do a study.
Why don't you? You appear to have plenty of time on your hands.
But Doctor, if you want to have your dessert, please go ahead. I won't be offended.
I have to go, and I'm sorry to leave while you're still eating.
No, no, I'm done as well.
But you've hardly touched your plate.
If you really must know, I've been nibbling on Delavian chocolates all morning.
When did you get Delavian chocolates?
Well, I promised my supplier I wouldn't tell, but since I deprived you of your dessert, I'd be more than happy to bring some by the infirmary later this afternoon.
Why, thank you. I'd like that.
Until then, Doctor.
Well, I suppose Garak taught me to think of lunch as a sort of arena for philosophical debate.
Out with the speed! What could have happened?
I'm afraid the fault, dear Tane, is not in our stars, but in ourselves.
What?
Something I learned from Dr. Bashir.
I take it there's still no word about Garak and Odo.
The starship Portland and a Cardassian cruiser are still searching the Algira sector for the runabout.
As a matter of fact...
Bashir to infirmary. Medical emergency on the promenade.
It's Garak's shop.
As well as can be expected. But I'm afraid your pants won't be ready tomorrow after all.
Volterra, who used to be an agent of the Obsidian Order.
The Obsidian Order? Constable, you shouldn't put too much stock in the good doctor's flights of fancy. And of course, there's always Major Kira.
This is serious, Garak.
I'm being serious. I don't think she likes me.
She doesn't. But if she wanted you dead, you would be.
You do have a point. Such a tragedy. I met him once, a few weeks before he died. I was working as a gardener at the Cardassian Embassy during the...
You were a gardener on Romulus?
My specialty was Edosian orchids. Beautiful, but highly toxic.
As I recall, Proconsul Marak was poisoned.
Funny. I don't remember that. But then again, so many Romulan dignitaries died unexpectedly that year.
Must be hard to keep them all straight.
Well, you can't imagine.
Maybe we should let the constable get some rest.
I'll let you know when I need rest, Doctor. A gardener.
How do I look, Doctor?
Does it matter?
Of course it matters. I'm here as a representative of the Cardassian Empire, and I want to make a good first impression.
Be right outside. It can wait, Garak.
Yeah, of course.